Hi YouTube, this is a video for Taurus. I'm gonna do a Celtic cross spread for the whole month of November, not just a couple of days. Kind of to give you an overview on what the month is gonna be like, what to expect. We'll use just a couple cards from the energy deck, and then I'll do a Celtic cross with the Rider-Waite tarot. Okay, if you haven't already subscribed, please subscribe to my channel. Keeps me motivated and inspired to do these. Actually, I love doing these anyway. Okay, just helps to do them for somebody that's actually listening. We have the Magician card. Magician card and Appreciation. So, the Magician shows up when there's something in your life that maybe you don't realize you have the ability to manifest. It doesn't show up because all of a sudden there's this energy. It shows up to remind you that the energy to create whatever you want is already here. It's already within you. You just, I guess, need to be reminded of it again. And this Magician is balancing the hot and cold. He has the infinity sign, like the strength, from the Leo. Then Appreciation. This is all about having gratitude for what you do have in your life so that you can get more to come in, because you'll be in the receiving mode. And being in that receiving mode, you know what the law of attraction is, what it's all about. Being open, being not focused on one particular outcome, but focused on the system, the journey to get there, not the destination. And doing little bits of gratitude throughout your whole day, writing them down, really keeps you into that receiving mode. Okay, so for Taurus, let's get a Celtic cross for Taurus. For Tauruses, can't even say your sign very well this morning. Taurus. For Taurus. For the greater good of Taurus. Celtic cross. Oh. My poor little table. It's like had it. Wobbly. I keep seeing the Five of Swords come up. I don't know why. Now I've got the Five of Wands coming up. Might be seeing some fives in your day. I am always kind of, I don't know if I should say this because I'm not sure that this is a good reaction, but when I see fives in my life, especially if I see 555, I know to prepare myself because there could be some conflict. There could be some arguing. Or, you know, just might stand for some, you know how the tower can be something bad, but it also can just mean sudden change. That's the same for the fives. Same for the fives. It could just be a sudden change. And remember, not everything that we perceive to be bad is actually bad. Some of it is happening for our own good, and we just don't understand it at the moment. Hey, Taurus. Let me kind of shuffle these a little bit more. My card of contemplation came out. Somebody might be contemplating whether something was worth their investment or not. What do we have? And we have five on the bottom. So, yeah, you've got a lot of fives. I would expect there to be something involving change. There might be a commotion around you with that. For your situation, you are at a stalemate or a block. You can't see the outcome to a solution. So right now you may be sitting pretty in a little peaceful state, but there is a decision that needs to take place. There's something that needs to be done. This is a card telling you that there's a need for action. Then in the challenging, we have the Knight of Wands. If it's not a Leo, Aries, Sagittarius, it's somebody who is in and out of your life. They are kind of whimsical. They may speak before thinking, have a sense that things need to be hurried all the time, and in doing so, things can be rushed and things can be missed. So this is like the haphazardly card. In your foundation, you have the Six of Pentacles. You have the need for things to be equal, give and take of energy. If you've been putting in a whole lot of energy, this is the need for that balance to come. And we could be dealing with a Libra. We've got the scales right here. It could be about giving to charity, or it could be about receiving charity. But something, it has something to do with this block, with this stalemate. In the past position, we have the Ten of Swords. So we do have some heartache, some betrayal. It's the ending of it, though. It's the ending of a betrayal, the ending of something hurting you, something that hurt you. It's no longer hurting you anymore. It's actually not a bad card to get. You know, tens are endings, so it's not bad. In your present, we have the Ace of Wands. So if there was a need to make things even and balanced, and there's a need to make a decision, then Spirit's coming in and giving you that inspiration. They're giving you the answer. This is a gift. Look at it as a gift from the universe. You will know what to do card. Now in your near future, we have the Three of Wands. So this is that spirit right here of appreciation. It's all about anticipation, being in the receiving mode. It kind of ties in with the Magician too. All about waiting for your ships to come in. Watch with this card what you're turning your back to, though. Make sure that your focus isn't all on one thing, that it's balanced focus. Not much can compete with focus, you know. How you are feeling, we have the Wheel of Fortune. You may be feeling like the wheel spins whether you turn it or not. Let's put it that way. This is a lucky card, yes. It can be a card of some luck coming your way. It also has, you know, when it talks about luck, it does have to do with things kind of unfolding in the way that they were meant to. Maybe you feel like there's not much you can do to change a situation when you see this card there. In your external, we have Page of Wands. Could be talking about a child, Leo, Aries, Sagittarius. But this is actually, this card reminds me of the Ace of Wands, because the Ace of Wands is that inspiration, that new beginning that lets you know what's going to happen. And the Page of Wands is a new beginning. And you see the little spark, the little flame on top. That's that little inspiration. So that's that external inspiration that you're getting from the Ace of Wands. Just popping up again to show you that you need to stay inspired. Then we have King of Pentacles for your, we're going to put it for your hopes, since it's kind of a good card, you know. Somebody that can materialize things in their life. They know how to do it, and they use that heart-brain coherence. So they use their mind and their heart to think of things. It could be a Taurus, Virgo, or Capricorn. Then, in your outcome, we have Five of Cups. We have looking at spilt cups and not noticing those two right here that are full behind you. And it's kind of like what I said with this one, with the guy that's in anticipation, waiting for his ships to come in. He's still turning his back on something. See, that's what I noticed, is that he's turning his back on something. Let's get a clarifying card for the Five of Cups. Okay. So when you go deep down with the Hermit, and you dig down for information, you're looking within, not without, right? This is the card of Virgo, and all, what bubbles up to the surface are these emotions. You have the light, you know what needs to be done, you put some truth, shed truth on some things, and this card can come with a feeling of regrets, some sorrows, some wishing you had done it differently. But we can't stay in this energy too long. Introspection is great, but dwelling on something that happened in the past for too long is causing you to miss things that are here in this present moment. And here in this present moment is really all we have. If you live in the past, you'll be depressed. And if you live in your future, you'll always be anxious. All right, let's get some tea fortune cards. And we'll see if we can fit them in to our reading somehow. For Taurus. Need some cards for Taurus. Well, that's good. Okay. Could be dealing with an Aries. Got a Ram. Okay. Yeah, we have the Ram, so we could be dealing with an Aries, but this is representing a stubborn or aggressive person. Probably the person that's in your challenge. I would say that goes along well with that. Somebody that's stubborn, arrogant, does things kind of flippantly. I don't know if that's even a word, but it sounded good. We have Lily with spiritual love, definitely on appreciation. Lily, spiritual love. Then we have this to look for. This says wedge. Somebody is trying to come between you and a friend, or between you and something that you want. That could be why all the fives were showing up on your shuffle and then at the bottom of the deck. It could be to watch out for that. I'll put that there. Then we have January. Another sign got January. So we have the month of January. And we have, well, family wishes come true. Family wishes come true. I'll put that at the King of Pentacles. Oh, and then beautiful. Look, the Hermit lighting the way, finding things from the inside. And then the candle, you will be shown the way. You literally are going to be shown the way. Don't have any regrets or sorrows. There's no time for that. Just time for what's right here, right now. What we can do right now to change things. Okay, Taurus, thank you very much. I hope you enjoyed this.